We've all heard of problems that colleges have with sexual assault on campuses, but a new study released last week indicates that the problem is really even worse than anybody thought. The Now's Holony Davis joins us now with more on that.
I'm here with everything you need to know to protect your loved ones with lifestyle lawyer Sherry. We know a new report has come out kind of detailing or at least giving us some insight into how prevalent some of these college campus sexual assault cases are.
Right. And the problem is, Holony, on the macro level, this report shows us that it's a much bigger issue than we even thought. Mm. So previously we were thinking 1 in 5 girls were impacted by some kind of sexual issue when they were on campus, unwanted, coerced sexual activity. This report shows it's closer to 1 in 4, maybe even 1 in 3 at some of the more prestigious colleges, which you would not think. You know, that's almost counterintuitive that the more prestigious colleges have the bigger problems. We also, on the micro level, are seeing that freshmen, for example, are impacted much more significantly, almost 50% more often than upperclassmen. So, you know, as a parent myself of a freshman, college freshman, we worry, we send our kids off to school, they get the flu shot, things like that. We don't want them to get sick. Your college freshman is much more likely to have an unwanted sexual encounter her freshman year than she is to get the flu.
We've long thought this type of crime was underreported. This new report showing that is the case. In terms of laws, what can we do to protect ourselves, to protect
our kids? Well, and that's the problem, is up until recently, we really only had Title IX, which is a federal law that says if you're a college or university, you're getting federal money for programs, and you discriminate based on gender, the federal government can withhold that money. In fact, about 5 years ago, when this really came to the forefront, the Department of Education sent out a letter to all the colleges and universities and said, we will be using this leverage, but it's really a backdoor approach. So a few years after that, President Obama set up this task force, a White House task force, to investigate it. But this past summer is when some laws with real teeth were passed. There's an act that we call the Campus Save Act, for example, that now actually requires colleges and universities to take preventative measures and to change the adjudication process. So they can't handle a rape on campus, for example, the same way they used to handle cheating on a college exam. Mm.
You mentioned you're a mom of a college student. What do moms and dads out there to protect their kids that are in school, they're sending them to college? What can you do ahead of time?
Well, and that's the thing, because even with these new laws, it's going to take some time for them to really be implemented. So the number one tool that we are getting now is that the schools are required to file an annual security report on their websites. We need to take that tool and read it. Students need to read it so we know what the incidences are, and we need to apply pressure on the colleges and universities to fix
that. I like
that
middle tip right there, trusting your gut.
Trusting your gut is important when it comes to sketchy people and sketchy places. I mean, just because someone is your roommate's boyfriend, for example,
sure,
doesn't mean that they may not be a perpetrator. The other big issue is alcohol. So we need to coach our kids, never leave your drink unattended. Those huge vats of alcohol at frat parties are
number one no-no,
because you have no idea what's in it. And then the last thing is to really remember when you do see an incident or you see a friend in trouble to do something. 75% of these instances that actually go unreported because people are afraid they won't be taken seriously or they'll lose their anonymity. So teaching our kids really what to do if something like this does happen is important.
I see you have friends down there. Be your brother's, or in this case, your sister's keeper.
Keep your eyes open.
All right, Sherry. Shannon, back to you.
Thanks, ladies. Great information. We